TV 5, WMC TV, Memphis.
August 16th, 1977, will be remembered as the day Memphis lost a king, the king of rock and roll. Elvis Presley is dead at the age of 42. Tonight, we report the event and remember the man with a special edition of Action News 5.
You ain't no friend of mine.
Elvis's death this afternoon was swift and unexpected, as Mason Granger reports. I understand we're having trouble with the tape that Mason made earlier, but we do have Mason live, which is one up on the tape. So we go directly to Baptist Hospital, where Mason's been standing by most of the day. Mason?
Dick, Elvis Presley died here about 3:30 this afternoon. He had been found in his bathroom, unconscious, not breathing. Was brought to the hospital by ambulance. Efforts to revive him in the ambulance and efforts to revive him here at the hospital were unsuccessful, and Elvis was declared dead at 3:30. He had probably died earlier in the day, sometime between 9 and 2:30, doctors say. The last time he was found alive was at 9 o'clock. An autopsy was performed here this evening on Elvis's body, and according to doctors, the cause of death was cardiac arrhythmia. In other words, an unnatural heartbeat. Elvis evidently collapsed when his heart started beating out of tempo and then died. Doctors say they are not sure what caused the cardiac arrhythmia, although Elvis did have a history of hypertension, and he did have a cardiac disease which had not been detected before the autopsy was done. There has been a great deal of speculation here at Baptist Hospital all day long that what caused the death of Elvis Presley was drug abuse. And in fact, Elvis was taking drugs for hypertension, for a colon disease that he had, and he was taking appetite depressants. But according to his personal doctor, Dr. George Nicopoulos, none of those drugs is an amphetamine. And when I asked both the doctor who performed the autopsy and Dr. Nicopoulos if drugs were related to his death in any way, they both said no. But they did find traces of drugs in Elvis's body during the autopsy, and it won't be known what those drugs are for a number of days until further tests have been done. As a matter of fact, Elvis, his personal doctor said, was in generally good health. He had performed a checkup on Elvis just 4 or 5 days ago and said he was fit for a concert tour, which was scheduled to start tonight nationally, with two performances scheduled in Memphis later this month. Elvis's body has now been moved from here at Baptist Hospital to the Memphis Funeral Home, which is taking care of all funeral arrangements. Dr. Nicopoulos says he expects the funeral probably will be held on Thursday. Live at Baptist Hospital, this is Mason Granger, Action News 5. An ambulance brought the king of rock and roll to Baptist Hospital at 3 o'clock this afternoon. His road manager had found Elvis in his bedroom at his Graceland mansion, unconscious. He wasn't breathing. By the time the ambulance reached the hospital, efforts to revive Elvis had failed.
Our Harvey team, our emergency resuscitation team, began working with him and continued this effort until approximately 3:30, when his personal physician, Dr. Nicopoulos, discontinued this effort.
Elvis was dead.
The preliminary phases of the autopsy have been completed, and the cause of death is cardiac arrhythmia due to undetermined causes. Now, what this means is that there are several cardiovascular diseases present, which include a history of mild hypertension, which was under pretty good control, and some coronary artery disease.
At Bluff City Buick GMC, we have to move our remaining 77 Buicks and GMC trucks to make room for the new 78 models. And the only way to do that is to blow the lid off all 1977 prices. With hundreds of 77 Buicks and GMC trucks to choose from, we've got to offer the lowest prices in the entire Mid-South. But hurry, Milton Schaefer's money-saving mile won't last long at these low prices.
Remember, only Bluff City Buick GMC, the largest Buick dealer in the South, as dynamite deals like these.
DeSoto County is neighborhood lakes and forested parks.
All right, let's head up by the point.
We might get some better, Kelly.
Great neighborhood schools.
Did you have a good day?
Yeah, you want to race me home?
I sure do. I'll give you a head start.
Great neighborhoods.
My utility has been running a lot less than I expected.
I've been real surprised, too. I thought last winter...
Great neighbors.
Hi, neighbor!
And great neighborhood developments. DeSoto County, the neighboring place.
You're watching Helen Overton, well-known Memphis singer, rehearse. But Helen has another interest.
And that's Memphis State University. I like the way students can attend even at night or on weekends and take credit courses in so many new areas. I can hit a high C, but I bet there'll be a lot of A's and B's at Memphis State.
Watch it, Helen.
With Memphis State.
Almost any time of day, you could drive by Elvis's Graceland mansion and see a crowd of people outside the gates waiting to catch a glimpse of the king. Tonight, his fans are still there, gathering around each other. Eileen Jones is at the mansion right now with our live action cam. Eileen?
Some 300 people have gathered outside in front of the Presley home, and cars are backed up for miles in both directions down Elvis Presley Boulevard. It has been estimated that at least 2,000 people have stopped here this afternoon, all hoping for some word from the family that Elvis Presley really is dead. However, there's been no word from the Graceland Mansion. Only members of the immediate family are allowed inside. But one uncle did tell me earlier today that Elvis Presley was in his bedroom, got up to go to the bathroom, and that was when he fell on the floor. Fred Stoll has been a gateman here for some 14 years. Mr. Stoll, when was the last time you saw Elvis?
The last time I saw Elvis was last Wednesday morning, about 2 o'clock in the morning. He went out for a drive.
And how did he look to you then?
He looked like he's feeling well. He waved at the fans and was smiling.
No evidence of any physical problem?
No, he seemed like he felt well.
Thank you, Mr. Stoll. City officials have passed a resolution making tomorrow a day of mourning for Elvis Presley. All flags in the city are being asked to fly at half staff. Earlier today, I talked with some of the people who had gathered outside, and here on tape are some of their comments. From the moment it was announced that Elvis Presley was dead, fans and friends flocked to his house, and some stayed the whole day. Weeping, sobbing friends were just looking and hoping for some word that the tragedy wasn't true.
God, David, he was so close to Elvis. David.
Are you a relative or friend?
I knew Elvis for 20 years. I knew him.
We've been here waiting since Sunday night to get a glimpse of Elvis, and last night he left the house about 11 o'clock with some friends and came back in about 2:30, quarter to 3. And he was fine then, and he was smiling and waving, and he had his girlfriend in the car and his doctor and a couple of other people. And they drove up and they waved and everything, and he looked fine. That was about 2:30 or quarter to 3. And then, then this morning, then we were here again early this morning, and we saw the ambulance come, and the ambulance flew right in, and immediately we knew something was wrong, and they came right back down, and the ambulance was Elvis Presley's doctor, and they were working on him, and they wouldn't say who it was, but we figured it was him, but they said it was his grandmother.
How would you describe what you feel right now?
I can't believe it. I just can't. I've been a fan of Elvis since I was 16 years old. And my dream came true. My husband brought me up here yesterday to see Elvis's home, and I've waited 21 years for this, and I don't believe it. I just don't.
No funeral arrangements have been made yet. The Presley family says it's just too early to make those kinds of plans. However, it is believed that Elvis will be buried here in Forest Hill Cemetery, somewhere near his mother's grave. Eileen Jones, Action News 5. Oh.
Over 68 million Western Auto tires have crisscrossed America since 1909, like the famous LPS2, one of Western Auto's finest tire values. Tested and retested for today's driving with four tough plies of polyester cord, the LPS2 is on sale now. Get one tire at half price when you buy another at regular price, plus tax and trade, at your nearby Western Auto store.
Western Auto will be good to you.
How's the team, Coach?
Need to make some changes, Murph.
You also need an oil change.
Oh, substitution time, eh? Well, put in the fresh team.
All part of our full service. We carry a complete line of motor oil.
Oh, I carry most of it myself.
Oh, how is this 20W50?
Really stands up under heat.
It won't break down under pressure.
You'd stack it up against any motor oil made, eh, Billy?
If I had a chance.
Put a man with spirit on your side. The spirit of 76.
Homemakers Upjohn has nurses for home and hospital, Medicare approved. A service of the Upjohn Company, 767-2436.
The news of Elvis's death hit relatives and family members rather hard. One of them, his stepmother, Dee Presley. She talked with Roger Cooper earlier tonight.
Dee Presley was married to Elvis's father for 14 years. 3 years ago, they separated. Today, she lives in an East Memphis apartment where an easel in the living room holds a picture of her stepson.
He was everything. Elvis was the greatest stepson, friend. He was just everything to me and to my sons. And we loved him so much. I just can't believe it's happened.
What kinds of things would you like to do together when you were together?
Oh, I suppose our favorite time was Christmas. And playing in the snow, riding horseback, and just gathering around the piano and singing hymns at Graceland. Those were the special moments, I think, and with Lisa and Priscilla. We were a real close family.
Dee Presley says the separation didn't seem to affect her relationship with Elvis, and she stayed in close touch with the Presley family.
Was Elvis playful? Did he ever trick you or play a joke on you? You recall?
Yes, yeah, he did. He was very playful. He used to, the 4th of July, would have the fireworks, and Elvis used to just put off a firecracker or something right in the one of the dens to frighten everyone. And of course, I seemed to be the one a lot of times that he'd do it to. He liked to play tricks.
But you two got along pretty well.
Wonderful. Really great.
Mrs. Presley, thank you very much.
Thank you for coming. I'm so sad. I loved him so much. I hope you'll forgive.
During his life, Elvis Presley touched the lives of many, many people. But one life he touched very early was that of Louis Black. Louis is the son of the late Bill Black, the musician with whom Elvis started his career. So Louis came by our studios this evening, bringing his father's scrapbook and talking about what he remembers about Elvis Presley.
The main thing I remember about him was before they started playing professionally anywhere, that they used to play out in the front yard, Elvis, Scotty, and Meditti. And I used to just sit down under a big tree out there and just pick and grin, if you want to call it, and they went on and played around in a few places. I think they played up at Ford's Engine House and a couple of places around town there. They used to just try to play a little music.
So what did you think when Elvis became the king of rock and roll?
Well, I just couldn't believe it. I mean, you know, that my father was in something like it with him, you know, and to go places and it was really something, because everybody, all the kids would ask me, you know, I mean, what does Elvis look like? How does he look really in person? Is he a good man or what? And I said, well, yeah, he's fine. He's a real good fella to be around.
Is he a good man? Was he a good man?
Yes, he was. The main thing I remember about that was when my father passed away in 65, he come out to the house. And when he got ready to leave, before he left, he went over to my mother and he said, Evelyn, he said, I want to tell you that if there's ever anything that you or the kids ever need, he says, don't you ever hesitate. He says, you come and let me know.
What went through your mind when you first heard?
Well, I really couldn't believe it. I wanted to see what happened. Turned on the radio. The first thing I heard was the king of rock and roll has passed away.
Elvis Presley's music knew no color barrier. It appealed to black and white alike. Tonight, Sunbeam Mitchell, owner of the several Memphis night spots through the years, remembered Elvis.
He used to come up the stair there with his guitar, try to sit in with the musician things playing. So then at the time where I couldn't let him in sometimes we could, you know what I mean? But anyhow, he was a real nice fella, and I met him, and I let him in. He's sitting upstairs there with the musician and jammed a while. Then after Clifford Miller walked down on Hunter Anna Street, that's where he kept going down there with Bowlegs, a fella called Bowlegs Miller, band leader, during that time. But Mr. Dewey Phillips, he always was calling, because I think the radio station was in the Chiskey Hotel at the time. So that's how I know him.
His club seat there. Where were you today when you heard about Mr. Presley's death?
I was at the Sunbeam. It was just a shock. I didn't know what to do. I couldn't believe it.
Another man who knew Elvis rather well was Jimmy Fry, a special deputy with the Shelby County Sheriff's Department, who was assigned to Elvis and his entourage during many of his local activities. And he's here now to talk to Dave Brown. Dave?
Right, Jimmy, you used to kind of guard or police when Elvis would have a special function, is that right?
Yes, I first met Elvis when he would bring his boat to McKellar Lake, and I would run the patrol boat on McKellar Lake, and he would ride some with me and, around, and he liked to listen to the radio, you know, and know what was going on.
What about fairgrounds, places like that? You kind of appeared at all of these, wouldn't you?
Yes, I policed the fairgrounds for him when he would rent the fairgrounds after 12 o'clock at night, and he would always call me and want to know if I could work before he would rent them, and I would police them most of the time.
All right, you told me, too, that Elvis used to ride with you sometimes when you would make certain calls, not all of them, but he would ride with you sometimes and make calls, accidents and things like that. When was the last time you talked to him about that?
I talked to him Sunday night. I have a sheriff's radio in my private car, a company car. I work for Carrier Ready-Mix Concrete Company, too. And he would ride with me for a couple hours, and we would make some of the calls with some of the men, minor calls.
Any plans to ride?
Yes, he had planned to ride tonight if it would all have been possible for him to ride.
Before he left on the tour?
Right.
Okay, thank you. Jimmy Fry, special deputy with the Shelby County Sheriff's Department. Dick, we talked to one friend, a close friend of Elvis, also tonight out at Graceland, and he said he'd just prefer not to make a comment at this time.
I imagine a lot of people don't feel like talking about it right now, Dave. Thank you. There's other news tonight. A new FBI director named Son of Sam murder suspect pleads insanity. And James Earl Ray is suing Playboy magazine. These items and more are coming up next on Action News.
A good physical fitness program doesn't always have to be expensive to be effective. Do your health a favor.
At River City Dodge, we have a tradition of dealing right off the top of the deck. But at some car dealers, prices just don't reflect hidden costs like destination charges and dealer prep and other routine expenses that can turn a great deal into a bust. But River Jack's deals include destination charges, dealer prep, and there are no hidden costs, just big savings on all cars, trucks, and custom vans. River City Dodge, we may be hard to get to, but we're easy to deal with.
Everyone's rushing to Color Tile now for fantastic savings. Rushing for tile, rushing for wallpaper, rushing for paint. Everyone saves at Color Tile. Fantastic selection of first quality floor tile from only 12¾ cents in decorator colors and patterns. Color Tile's latex house paint is reduced to $9.99. Save on one coat latex wall paint, now only $5.99. Great for walls and ceilings. Rush to Color Tile for a huge in-stock selection of tile, wallpaper, and paint. Everyone saves at Color Tile.
Shop Color Tile.
Mr. Businessman, now is the time to place your ad in the new Suburban East, South, and Northeast business telephone directories, now featuring money-saving coupons. Call 398-9887.
A reminder that NBC will present a 30-minute special and tribute to Elvis Presley immediately following our newscast at 10:30. The Tonight Show will follow that at 11. In other news today, President Carter has chosen a new director for the FBI. He's Federal Judge Frank Johnson of Montgomery, Alabama. He's a Republican who issued a series of tough anti-discrimination decisions in the late 1950s. The man accused of being Son of Sam pleaded innocent in New York City today to charges of second-degree murder. David Berkowitz will probably rely on a defense of insanity. Meantime, the parents of Sam's last victim plan to sue the city of Yonkers for $10 million. A teenager accused of wounding two people in Michigan yesterday may be tried as an adult. He's accused of shooting a newsboy and a man who tried to help the newsboy. The newsboy may be paralyzed. James Earl Ray has filed a $1 million suit against Playboy magazine. He claims the magazine libeled him in publishing the results of a recent lie detector test. Gerald Richard Moles still missing, so are four bags of money from local food stamp offices. The case went to the county grand jury this morning, but because of Moles being a fugitive, officials cannot tell whether he's been indicted or not. At the state constitutional convention in Nashville today, Governor Blanton spoke his mind, and the interest rate committee talked about raising the 10% ceiling on bank interest rates. A county grand jury said today the city court system is full of crime because of faulty record keeping, especially in handling traffic tickets. But the grand jury offers no solution to that problem. Shelby County firefighters are now organized. 80 of the 99 firemen are members of the new union, but county officials may not recognize them. And city teachers are still talking about striking when school starts next week, but negotiations with the city are speeding up, so the battle over insurance benefits may be finished by that time. City school bus drivers also threatening to strike, but they're still talking with R.W. Harmon Company about a new contract. That, too, may be settled by the time school starts next week. The Wildcat walkout by United Mine Workers now affects more than 80,000 coal miners in four states. Many miners in West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania say they're staying off the job only because they're afraid of other strikers. And the Labor Department is afraid of the League of Women Voters, obviously, so it will force federal construction contractors to hire more women. The price of cigarettes is going up. Manufacturers will raise the wholesale price 17 cents a carton, and that increase will soon be passed on to consumers. Stocks fell to a 19-month low on Wall Street today. Dow Jones Industrials down almost 5 points. 65 stocks down almost 2 points. The trading today was moderate. And now with a look at the weather, here's Dave Brown again. Dave?
All right. Thank you, Dick. Kind of an abbreviated weather cast tonight. Right now in Memphis, temperature is 84 degrees. 84 degrees at 10 o'clock. We have a cold front which is pressing on us. It looks as though this front will make it to Memphis, maybe even through here. Exactly where it's going to stall, we don't know. It will be fairly close, but as it comes toward us, there will be an increasing chance for some rain showers. Let's take a quick look at our 150-mile range radar now. We can see there are a couple of thunderstorms. They're about 53,000 feet tall up in northeastern Arkansas and around the Arkansas-Missouri border. They are not moving toward Memphis, but up in that area, some fairly heavy thunderstorms. Forecast for tonight, partly cloudy skies in the city, thunderstorms to the northeast. Those thunderstorms are not moving toward Memphis tonight. The low 76, wind southwest at 9. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy. Chance for rain tomorrow afternoon, more likely tomorrow evening. The high 86. And wind southwest at 9. Action weather 5-day forecast looks like this. Thursday, partly sunny with a high of 86. Friday, partly sunny, high temperature 89 degrees. Saturday and Sunday, it'll be partly sunny each day. The high temperature on Saturday, 93. The high temperature on Sunday is expected to be about 91 degrees. Again, right now in Memphis, 84 degrees, skies partly cloudy.
Okay, Dave, thank you very much. We will return in just a moment with more on Elvis Presley.
Until now, you had to wait for frost to kill green weeds before soybean harvest. But now you have Paraquat. Paraquat burns back green weeds in a hurry to get you into the fields earlier. Paraquat, the harvest aid from Ortho.
The rip roaring ride, ripping and roaring all over the place, and all the spectacular shows all day long for one admission price.
Some go in and some go out. Liberty Land is where fun's all about.
Meet Joe Snyder. Memphis Bank and Trust merchant for both MasterCharge and Visa. Now, Joe's Hickory Farm store has only one merchant number for both cards. That's one number to call for authorization. So without separating the tickets, he makes one deposit, he gets one statement. MasterCharge and Visa from one bank. That's one step ahead for retailers. Memphis Bank and Trust business is the business of Memphis, helping you make it work.
Bank on it.
See the Bud Davis selection of 77 Cadillacs at special year-end prices, 5433 Poplar.
Once again, NBC plans a 30-minute special on Elvis Presley immediately following this newscast. The Tonight Show and the Tomorrow Show will be seen in its entirety beginning at 11. Much has been said tonight and will be said in coming days about Elvis Presley and the mark he has left in the world. It's impossible, of course, to condense all of the highlights of such a career into just a few minutes. But here's Frank Gardner with a brief look back.
Rarely has the American dream been lived so fully. It was a rags-to-riches story, a classic. Elvis Aaron Presley, born in Tupelo, Mississippi, January 8, 1935. His twin brother died at birth. His father was a cotton farmer and sometimes carpenter and factory worker. The young Elvis got his first singing experience in the choir of the local Assembly of God Church and at revivals and camp meetings. The boy got his first guitar as a birthday present when he was 12. He learned to strum chords, but he never learned to read music. The family moved to Memphis when Elvis was 13. He went to Humes High School and worked as an usher in the nearby theater. After graduation, he took a job at $35 a week driving a truck. His career actually struck its first spark in 1953. Elvis dropped by the Old Sun Record Company in Memphis and plunked down $4 to cut a personal record. A year later, he did another record at Sun, but this one, That's All Right, Mama, was released in 1954. It wasn't a smash, but some clever observers, even at that early date, detected something new and special. It was a blend of hillbilly and rock and roll. Then came the biggest turning point in the Elvis career. A shrewd promoter named Colonel Tom Parker took over management of Elvis and toured him through rural areas of the Mid-South under the name of the Hillbilly Cat. Then came the 1954 Country DJ Convention in Nashville, where RCA decided to sign him to a contract. The company quickly made history by releasing five Elvis records at the same time, and the kid from Memphis was soon responsible for half of RCA's pop music production. Throughout the mid and late 50s, constant stream of Elvis hits, Hound Dog, Don't Be Cruel, All Shook Up, It's Now or Never. The long sideburns, the swivel hips, the dark eyes, the skin-tight pants, and the electric guitar made a dent in the teenage consciousness that has rarely been so deep in all of pop music history. There were the famous three appearances on The Ed Sullivan Show, and then an incredibly successful string of movie hits, beginning with Love Me Tender, then Loving You, Jailhouse Rock, and on and on and on. But Elvis made his strongest impact in the personal appearances. One Life magazine writer wrote in 1956, "They get set off by shock waves of hysteria, going into frenzies of screeching and wailing and winding up in tears." He was a millionaire by the time the Army called in 1958. Who doesn't remember the old newsreel shots of the young Elvis having his shiny black locks shorn by the Army barber in Fort Chaffee, Arkansas? His Army career was fairly routine. As routine as it can be when you're a millionaire and your name is known around the world. After a tour of duty in Germany, Elvis came back to his career, and there were more hits, more concerts, and more movies. And throughout the good years, lots of generosity, always remembering family and friends and many fans with money, cars, and trips. In 1967, he married Priscilla Ann Ballou. A daughter was born a year later. Then the couple separated in 1972. Elvis went into semi-retirement in the late 60s with 400 million records and 31 motion picture films to his credit. And then in 1972, a brief reappearance, and the fans were still faithful. There were sellouts, four of them, at Madison Square Garden alone. In fact, he finally became a prisoner of his own home and his hotel rooms, everywhere, mobbed by crowds. Although he was hospitalized five times in recent years, his doctor had found him in good health after a physical exam just this past April. He had been noticeably overweight in recent years and had been plagued with hypertension. Finally, this afternoon, the pressure that came with the title of the King of Rock and Roll had taken its physical toll. Many critics feel that Elvis Presley was the most important popular musical figure of the third quarter of the 20th century. Some musicologists believed that it was Presley alone who had liberated American pop music from the European tradition. Frank Gardner, Action News 5.
Tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you.
From the Action News team, good night, and stay tuned for an NBC report. Will